We are joined by Pawan sir now, Mr. Pawan Desai. He is the co-founder and CEO of Midcat Advisory. So this is basically a security and a full service security firm, both physical as well as cyber. Pawan sir is an ex-lieutenant commander with Indian Navy, and then post his service career, he has started this venture by the name of Midcat Advisory. He specializes in information security. With that experience, it becomes very meaningful hours to have his experience here and draw from him what he faced during the last 4 or 5 months and what could be a practical and streamlined mitigation approach. Over to you, Pawan sir.
Thanks a lot. So let me get over with two common questions. Am I audible and is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Right. I think I was listening to both the speakers today. I think Supratim and Kunal and Om chipped in. I think it's a great start to the day. A lot of points to think about. I'm going to focus purely on the cybersecurity aspect of it and the challenges what we have. And it is even more important because earlier I think we used to leave cybersecurity to security people. I think this is in this era, like a lot of people say that I think culture of the organization, you cannot leave to lower team members, or you cannot leave sales to only the sales guys. The management has to take responsibility to it. Similarly, I think security now you cannot say my IT security head is only going to be responsible, or the CISO is going to be responsible of it. Especially the management, the HR teams, it is very, very critical for them to understand first the problems and take ownership of, because most of the problems which are going to come, which are already come in last 6 months and which are going to come in future, is because of the employees and the people, and mainly because of their carelessness or their unawareness. That is where which is going to come. So I'm going to talk about those things. Where do we stand today, and where does the future, what does the future look like? So always like to start with that. Yes, this is the new normal. Everybody talks about that terminology, new normal. I'm not going to talk about that. Yes, the era is going to be different. We are not going to go back to the state what we were pre-COVID. So it is going to be a new situation. It is going to be a new normal. One more point I would like to add to this. There is no precedence to this. When I say precedence, yes, a lot of people have handled crisis, localized crisis, big crisis, but nobody has faced a crisis of this scale, nature, and intensity, as well as the coverage. So nobody can say that I am an expert in this. So if I have spoken to so many CISOs, so many CIOs in last 6 months, everybody, when they sit one-on-one with, they might put a very, very brave face in front of you, or they may say, don't worry, everything is fine. But when they actually, you sit with them, you will realize that everybody is scared, everybody, and nobody knows where things are going. So there is no precedence of this, and everybody is struggling with the situation, and we are all living every day. And as the day is progressing, so we are all learning as we are moving. So there is no specialist in this. Nobody can say that, come to me, I'll solve all your problems. If somebody is saying a person is a bluff, or he doesn't know what is he talking about. So everybody is figuring out as we are moving. And yes, we are doing a great job. I don't want to undermine the capabilities and the way people have come out, the innovativeness with the people have come out with the solutions. People are doing a fantastic job, but nobody has an idea that are we really safe or we are not really safe. Only the time is going to tell in that. So that's the state which we are in. Just to put certain, I think, context to the whole thing, the IT has been the biggest disruptor in terms of positively as well as negatively, because with all the digital push, everybody wants to move to digitization, everything. There has been an explosion to the entire network. So now the network doesn't exist for an organization. It has become so big that you actually do not cannot have a boundary which was there. It has become a more of a boundaryless organization. And that is where the all the risks, all the problems, all the susceptibility, all the errors comes into play. The proliferation of apps, devices. Earlier, I had the BYOD policy. I had my laptop. I had my phone. And you need to configure all MDMs or mobile device management and everything on my two devices. But when I started working from home, I might be working from my iPad because my school, son's school or daughter's school is going on. So my laptop is being used by them. I might be using other mobile because my daughter's school is going on that. So the number of devices have become so huge, and to put control over that is almost next to impossible. And to top it up, regulations are evolving. So earlier, if you say anybody from the banking industry, it was a strict no-no. Work from home, it is not possible. But things have moved. Things have changed drastically. And because of that, and if you see, the NASSCOM is now actually lobbying for all the ITS to continue this whole thing. Because most of the places we had put controls and thinking that this is a stopgap arrangement. This is going to only go for 2 months, 3 months, 6 months kind of thing. But this is going to be a new normal. So in that, we'll have to reinvent and re-evolve the entire security strategy. And we'll have to rethink. The stopgap arrangement is not going to work in the future. So just to give certain statistics in place, very quickly, there has been almost 238% rise in attacks on banks. 80% of the companies who have been surveyed by NASSCOM have complained about cyber attacks and increased cyber attacks. So irrespective of you're a small company, medium company, banking industry, healthcare industry, whatever you are, the cyber crime or cyber attacks have increased. Almost 630% increase in cloud-based attacks. Phishing attempts have increased to 776% compared to February, which is there. Anybody who thinks Apple is more protected, the attacks have increased. So when they say 10% of attacks are happening on Apple, but you have to see where it was, the Apple was very, very low in terms of attacks. So the increase has been phenomenally high for Apple devices. There has been 5%, five times increase in home working attacks. One of the six domains you visit about statistics of coronavirus, maybe how much increase happened, is a fake domain or a spurious domain which is trying to steal, either doing some attack or trying to get data or trying to put malware on your devices. I can go on this. So just to sum it up in terms of challenges, the last 2 points in the orange box, every 39 seconds. So since the moment I have started speaking, we must have had almost 20 more attacks, which is there. And we are talking about India. We are not talking globally. Globally is much more on that. And most 75% of the attacks starts with emails, which is there. So this is the era which we are living in. As HR professional, one more point I'll like to add, which is there. 67% of data breaches results from credential thefts, human error. Human error is very, very important because most of HR people are going to deal with employees, and we'll touch the point of why it is happening on that thing in the future slides. Just to give you a view on the attack surface, it is very, very important to understand anything we want to protect. We want to understand how much is it exposed to. We used to call it in our schools and colleges, we must have learned about surface area. If the surface area is lesser, the impact is lesser. With the new normal of everybody working from everywhere, the attack surface has increased drastically. So let's define the attack surface in a very non-technical terms. You start from software as a service. So most of the times now we are looking at, we don't want to have anything, any softwares, anything build, or we will use off-the-shelf softwares, and we will paper use. Kind of the entire world is moving towards paper use or whatever use model. So software as a service is becoming predominant in our entire digitization journey. So that is one of the biggest exposure, because we do not know what kind of security controls have they put in place, kind of thing. we have control over our own softwares and our own devices, but we have no control or a very less control over softwares which we are using paper use kind of a thing. The mails, yes, which is there. The third most important aspect is the IoT devices, which with the digitization push so much in place, we are adding so many IoT devices. Everything has become smart. But is it secure? We are not sure. Most of you will be having cameras in your premises. At some of you might be having at homes also. 80% and more cameras have a default password. So I know if you have a camera from Hikvision or Bosch or a Honeywell, I know what password it has. If it is a IP based cameras, which are IP based nowadays, I can actually straight away get into your device. I don't need to do any exploit for that kind of a thing, because the default password has been put for ease of maintenance. It is not from a security perspective kind of thing. So most of the IoT devices which are coming into your energy meters, your everything which we are connecting now to our IP systems are going to be much more exposed. And the speed of change has, COVID has increased the rate of digitization. So IoT devices, one of the biggest vulnerable areas. And in next 2 to 3 years, we are going to see most attacks which are going to happen are not going to be from IT systems. They are going to be from OT systems or IoT systems, which is going to happen. Mobile devices, of course, because earlier it was only one mobile device per employee. Now you have 4 mobile devices per employee, because you might be using your spouse's mobile, your kid's mobile, your parents' mobile to do the same work of office. So the attack surface area has increased tremendously. Same way we talk about your desktops, laptops, iPads, whatever you are using from home, and the Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is again one of the most vulnerable points which can be broken, and the entire layer of security which you have kept in your corporate network can be bypassed on that thing. What is happening? Yes, the attack surface area has increased. So what is attacking you? One, if you start from the right side of the slide, the malwares. So most of the sites, spurious sites or sites which is giving you a lot of inputs about coronavirus or Arogya Setu, PM Relief Fund, a lot of things are basically deploying malware on your systems. Ransomware attacks have increased drastically. IoT attacks are increasing. More and more people are now relying, actually exploiting IoT devices and getting into your networks because it is easy. Security is very, very minimal compared to your IT networks kind of thing. Non-standard ports, because when we buy our laptops or desktops or phones for our homes, security is never a, convenience is the main part, because we always think it is a home device. Why should we worry about security? But when we start using it for official purposes, we have most of the ports because as a Windows system, when you buy any system, it is not meant for security. So most of the port, so it's an open system compared to an Apple system. Apple is a closed system. So when people say that Apple is more secure, it is not more secure, because when it comes to you, most of the ports and most of the privileges are closed. You need to open every privilege. So it's a closed system. It is not meant for open architecture, but Windows system is an open architecture. Most of the ports and privileges are open. You need to actually close it to make it more secure. So whenever you're using home-based devices, by default, they are open systems. And that's why they are more vulnerable to most of the attacks which are there. Phishing attacks, yes, we have a habit of tampering with a lot of links and this thing, and they are becoming much more sophisticated. We do not have time today, so we are not going to talk more about phishing, but yes, that is, you should read it up on that. But this is where everything gets bypassed. So every million and billion dollar investment your organization is doing in security, if you are your employees, and HR is very, very important for you to understand, if your awareness is not continuous and continuously you're not bombarding your employees with continuous awareness and various case studies on phishing and ransomware, somebody is going to click on it. And once a person is inside, they will find a way. So it is not about one person getting infected. It is like a coronavirus. So once a person gets impacted, the network is going to get impacted. You can delay it by having lockdowns. You can delay it by having controls, but it is not going to go away. So it is not all a problem of one person. It is the problem. Compromise happens for the entire network. That is the problem. In addition to that, there will be malicious code. So when they will connect to when the home devices gets connected to the device, to the official networks, the malicious code travels inside and they can infect the entire network on that. And the last part, which is the most dangerous, is the unknown vectors. We really don't know as of now. With the entire COVID era or whatever happening, the entire attacks, if you see India-China situation currently or whatever current, the amount of cyber attacks which is coming from a country to country, it has increased phenomenally. So, and that is very, very difficult. There is very, very sophisticated attacks. So don't think only competition is interested in your data. Even the rival countries are also focusing on corporates and they are attacking, which is because of cyber warfare, which is happening. So the chances of India-China physical war is much lesser compared to the amount of cyber warfare which we are daily facing against each other kind of thing. So this is the threat vectors, or this is the amount of bullets which is hitting us every day. And we have to run our organization in spite of this thing. None of the bullets are going away. They are getting fiercer, bigger, and more sophisticated. So this is the era in which we are living. So I think I'll just quickly cover this. Spikes in phishing, malware, ransom is happening. What they are working on, they are actually attacking on our fear. So they are working on fear, our vulnerabilities. Whatever we are vulnerable, we are fearful against. COVID, what is happening, India-China war, whatever we are thinking, whatever we are reading, attacks are actually happening from those kind of domains. And those, the news are popping up and we are clicking on that, and that is where we are getting impacted. And to add it up, our alert capabilities, because earlier it was a restricted domain, we had boundaries, our capability to react was much, much stronger. That has really, really gone down because our admins, our security teams are sitting in different locations. Their capabilities have reduced drastically. So all these things are happening. So where are we moving? We are moving towards a borderless security models. So border doesn't exist. So we have to be suspicious about everything in IT parlance. I'm not talking about human parlance, but in terms of IT thing, we are moving towards a domain where it's a no trust or a zero trust. We do not trust anyone. Everybody has to provide credentials, then only we'll let person in, or credentials with multi-factor authentication. Only when earlier we were moving towards a trust models. Okay, if a domain is this, the same, if a person name is this, if a person is logging in during these times, we will let a person in. It was more trust-based models. Now we are moving towards a zero trust models in IT parlance, which is there. So to add it up, to summarize the challenges, I'll just take next 5 to 7 minutes on that. I've divided it into 6 domains. One is increased risk from remote working, delays in responses, perimeters is exposed, cyber criminals have increased, BCP, our business continuity plans, were grossly inadequate, which we have realized, and cutting down on cybersecurity budget. Let's give 1 minute to each aspect and let's understand why it is happening. And and it is very, very important for this to be understood by the non-technology people. Because what happens is when we go for a budget cut, we say cut budget across. But if you are going to cut budget of cybersecurity in this era, the amount of damage which you are going to do to your organization is going to be phenomenal. So we have to be very, very understanding, and awareness levels have to be much higher on this. So let's understand the first challenge, which is increased risk from remote working. We have discussed a lot of points. But let me just put 3 areas which are very, very predominant, which is happening. One is the misconfiguration of your VPNs. Now, everybody will be saying that now organization has given me VPN, so I don't worry about that. But the speed at which the VPN implementation has happened and the companies, number of companies which have popped up in the last 6 months, which provides VPN services, is phenomenally high. So there are so many chances that configuration would not have happened So basically, you might have added locks or you have bought locks, but the key is available to everyone. So that lock doesn't have a meaning, kind of thing. So very, very important to reconfigure for your requirement, or maybe take a step back. Yes, for last 3 months, because the we wanted to give a remote working facility to our teams. It's a good time to rethink about the configuration and is it really, really secure on that thing. Do a reconfiguration checks of that. Second is exposure of devices for DDoS attacks. Most of the devices, so if you think DDoS stands for distributed denial of service. So most of your devices, trust me, are already infected. If you get a scan done, you will it has to be done by a professional. Now, why are they interested in your devices? So just to give a perspective in place, most of the smartphones or the phones which are in your hand or which are in your table currently, which are there, or if you are logged into from there, that phones have the computing capability equivalent to the Sputnik 1, which went to the space in 1957, if I'm not wrong on the years. That is the amount of computing power which your phone has currently. I'm not talking about laptop, I'm talking about your phone, which has currently. So most of the attackers are using your phone or a laptop or your iPads or your tablets for launching a DDoS attack. So these are called zombie machines. So most of your devices are zombie machines currently. And in last 6 months, it has been a play field for attackers to increase and infect your devices. And they are using these machines as a zombie machine to attack ICICI, HDFC, Bank of America, whatever they want to launch attack on, maybe Merrill Lynch or anyone. So they are using your machines to launch an attack to that. So that is what is important to understand. So cleaning up your devices is very, very important. And third and most important is that use your personal devices now for official work you have done. So if your machine is infected, your official network has a very, very high chances of getting impacted, which was not earlier. So these are the key risks which are happening from working from home, which is there. Second aspect, I think...
Can I ask a question?
Yes, please.
Sorry, can you just go back to the previous slide? So here, when you talk about the VPN, let me take an example. We have systems which are VPN enabled, but if we are also on cloud based and the single sign-on authentication is there, and some of the employees may use because of cloud single sign-on and they just don't use the VPN. How do you interpret that kind of a challenge here?
First thing is, in current environment, if they are working from home, very dangerous to not use it, kind of a thing. Not using a VPN. Not using a VPN?
No, so it's not mandatory for all the employees. Generally, we have got authentication codes coming onto our mobiles as well. But I'm just bringing a case that, if somebody is not using and educating them of the challenges of not using the VPN just because of single sign-on connection and being on the cloud environment.
Very dangerous. Very dangerous.
Okay. Got it.
So I think education is the key. I don't think so there is any other way to do it. Technology is available and the cost is minimal. So it's not about which is there. But I think education is going to be the key on this aspect. We need to use. Yeah. Thanks. Right. Should I move in on this? Thanks. I'm skipping a few slides because I think the message is well given. So many attacks have been increased on Aarogya Setu or on government bodies and everything what you're seeing. And that is increasing drastically. This is, I don't know, is it visible? The slide is visible. This is just a new index which has come. I'm just, which is a cyber intent index, there is a study which is done by on the capability of each country on various objectives like surveillance, defense, control, intelligence, commerce, offense, and norms. So this is where stands. So China stands at almost 80.3 out of 100 marks. If you see, India is at 34.7. This is a gap in terms of our capability, our intent kind of thing. So it's a huge, huge And this is what will get exploited by a lot of people who are interested in our systems kind of thing. We don't have to go through the each point of this each country, but I think just wanted to say where do we stand and where the other country stands in this context. Second point out of the six boxes, which was one is the second is a delay in response. So earlier when our teams had a SOC teams, which was sitting the IT network security, application security, CISOs, everybody was sitting together. They were functioning together as a team. Now they are disjointed. Now because of this disjointment, the effectiveness of the team has actually come down drastically. Because the, now it is very, very difficult because at a low level team figure out something. Earlier it was very easy to just to tell your manager that this is what is happening. Tell me what is the implication of this, and you were able to take action on that. But now because everybody is sitting from home, you are not able to corroborate or correlate a lot of attack patterns which are happening. And because of that, the efficiencies are going down. And what needs to be done now by all the HRs which are there, you need to actually train your low-level security teams much better compared to earlier days, because they are going to be your first line of defense if they are not really trained well. Earlier, they were only supposed to collect data and hand it over to your senior teams. But now because of this disjointment and they are operating in different places, it's very, very important to retrain and reskill them so that they are able to actually figure out if there is anything happening and alert the team accordingly, which is there. Currently, the detecting and responding capabilities have drastically reduced kind of thing. Patching, because it was you were coming into the network, your patches were possible. It was comparatively easy in the earlier environment, which was there. But in current environment, because now you're using five devices from your home and the other devices are not patched when we are using the office network kind of thing, the patching capability, why it is important? Because the what are patches? Patches are basically any vulnerability which you have found in last few days. Microsoft, Windows, everybody comes with a patches, which is there. And they every week, every 2 days, 3 days, depends on the criticality, this patch gets deployed in your network and all the machines get patched. But when this doesn't happen, the old vulnerabilities will remain in your machine and the chances of exploitation of that becomes much, much higher because the your machines are not updated to that level. And a lot of security teams are non-operational because maybe because of physical reasons also. Now your system admin might be staying, take an example of Mumbai, might be staying in Vasai or a Virar, and number of COVID cases or maybe Dharavi or nearby, and the number of COVID cases are very, very high kind of thing. Physically, you may need to have backups of your security teams. I'll just take with my experience. My security team was unoperational, not operational. We have a very small company. We are only less than 100 people. But we had a IT team of two people. But what we realized is both the people were staying in the same area. And both of them got impacted at the same time, unfortunately, the kind of thing. So our security capability actually were not, during certain phases, we could not do anything. They were not available during that time, which was there. So a lot of things, not only that technology part, but the human aspect also becomes very important of that. I'll skip this slide also. If you have recently been aware of Cognizant was hit by a ransomware attack, Maze, which is there. So every ransomware has a different functionality. Let me just quickly take you back to the slide. So what they do is just pay focus on the blue boxes, black boxes, which are there. They will do initial access. They will do credential theft. They will then laterally move. They will do lateral movement within the organization, within the network. Then they will do persistent attacks. So they will do certain big, so they will remain in the system and actually damage the system. And then every payload. So the Maze payload, if you go to the blue line, which is there. So it is a initial access was done by the RDP, which is the remote desktop access, which you have, but which is typically used by the administrator to to take care of your machines remotely. So they use that RDP brute force kind of thing. And then they did something called the Cobalt Strike for the lateral movement. And they did the GPO changes, which is a group policy organization, which is called as. So which is there, which actually make changes to all your policy related things. Just a GPO example is, suppose three passwords and the and your machine will or your account will be blocked is a GPO level policy. They may make changes to that, and you can bypass all the kind of things in that. So various payloads have they have different capabilities. They can do different activities. Just this is more for interest to know. You may not go into the detail, just for knowing what happened during Maze kind of thing. So Maze was an very interesting thing where Infosys, it was a third party attack actually. So Cognizant was attacked because the thing was done by Infosys, which had outsourced certain activities to a third party in Bangalore. Of that, some part was outsourced to a local vendor. And that is where the entire thing moved on that thing. And that's how the entire attack happened. And it was one of the biggest attacks which happened in recent past on that. Third, this thing is physical security and the perimeter. Yes, the quality of connection. So you are doing and patching. You are sitting in remote area. Your updation doesn't happen because the Wi-Fi connectivity is bad. Power. Some of us will be living in a places where the power supply is not a challenge. But trust me, a lot of people, when you go to the L1 level people, one level down kind of a people, most of the L1 resources of the IT security, they stay in places where power supply is real challenge kind of a thing. They may be actually, we had the cases where the system administrator used to go to a cyber cafe and used to do the, because his machine was not operational. So he used to go to a cyber cafe because it was his friend's cyber cafe. During the lockdown periods, and that is where they used to use a public desktop to take care of your machines. See the kind of vulnerabilities which can come from there. It's a different level altogether. And IoT devices. Now, your Google Home and your Alexa is connected to your machine, and your machine is connected to your network, and that's how the entire vulnerability comes into the whole thing. And that is the exposure which we are talking about. Next level is about now the people angle of it. Cyber criminals have increased drastically in last 6 months. If you go the chatter, if you hear on the dark web and deep web, and they are all on fear. Everybody is talking about global downsizing, which is happening. Anxiety levels are more. Now, if you see a cybersecurity guy, your IT security team or a system admin guy, now the capability is equal. So there is no difference in the capability what he has and the attacker or the hacker has. Both have equal capability. It is only the intent which changes. And a person who has anxiety, and if you have been laid off, and you, if your employee engagement levels are low, yes, that person can do harm because he already has the key to your network. He already knows the admin passwords, and that's where the there are and we have seen cases in many cases in past. And this is applicable especially to a smaller organization, medium sized organization, where you want to lay off an IT guy because you think cost is high, and that person has access to everything what you have, and they can run and havoc on your network. On that, I think I'll just skip a few of the slides, which is there. BCP, I think again, no organization can claim that they had prepared for such an eventuality. They had prepared for 5%, 10%, 20%, 30% work from home, maybe for 2 days, 3 days, 5 days, 1 week. Nobody had prepared for this kind of eventuality. So most of the BCPs are irrelevant in current context. We have to redraw in our mind first that what is going to be our new normal, how it is our new business operations are going to be. And based on that, start creating the BCP entirely again. The current plans are not going to, they have not worked, and they are not going to work on that thing in future, which is there. Lot of challenges, I think HR people, so very, very important, the willpower, sticking to a routine, power naps are not now going to 2 hours sleep in the afternoon. So many things are happening. Your Wi-Fis are not secured. Somebody wants to ask, say something? Okay, right. Those are happening. Another box which is there, cutting down on cybersecurity budget. This I tell to every organization that you may like to cut down on budgets. Yes, global recession is happening. India has been down by 23.6%, if I'm not wrong, in the last quarter kind of a thing. Cybersecurity should be the last area where you should be cutting your budgets on, because that is going to really, really impact you. In fact, most of the organizations which we are seeing have increased their cybersecurity spends, because you have to do remote monitoring. You have to put a lot of additional controls in place. Active monitoring, where the passive monitoring happening, people are moving towards active monitoring so that they can nip in the bud if there is a pattern which is developing or an attack which is developing. So cybersecurity is where you need to increase your spend if you really have to stay at the level which you were at pre-COVID. If you are going to cut budgets in this domain, trust me, it is going to be really, really catastrophic in your area of that. Another area which I feel most of our cybersecurity policies, if you see, a lot of you might be having ISO 27001, a lot of plans on certification must be there. Focus was more on confidentiality part of it. Predominantly, it was confidentiality dominated framework and a standard. But now equal importance has to be given to integrity and availability also. Because people have realized, the people who didn't focus on availability of the availability aspect of that, they have really, really got hit hard during last 6 months. So equal importance has to be given when you are creating your policies and controls from cybersecurity perspective to confidentiality, integrity, and availability. To do that, just as an immediate steps to do, it's a time to act, not to think. Don't go with that procurement plan of 6 months there. We are going to implement DLP or we are going to implement VPNs. It is not a 6 month process now. You have to do it now. You maybe do it 80% right. That is fine, but do it. A lot of times I have been asked this question, is cloud more secure or is on-premise more secure? It doesn't matter. It's just a place where your servers are kept. It really doesn't matter. It is very, very important. How have you evaluated? How have you assessed the entire process? And how have you secure? If you do not secure cloud, it is as insecure as on-prem. If you have done right security, on-prem is as secure as cloud. So security, cloud doesn't give you security. It is what do you buy? What services do you buy on the cloud that gives you security or not security? So on-prem and cloud has no difference. It depends on what you're buying. Test remote accesses security. If you are providing VPNs, if you are providing other accesses, test it regularly. Very, very important. Create separate private connections. So if you have to create for your senior management, so earlier you used to have LANs, which was you have various different domains or various within a network, you had various sub-networks for senior management, for R&D teams. Now, again, you need to separate those connections. If you have to have a senior management or a certain conversations or certain domains which you do not want to add to everyone, create those kind of thing. Proactive communication. Yes, the question was asked. Proactive communication and sensitization of employees, topmost priority, and it has to be continuous activity. Humne COVID start hua tha, tab kar diya tha, is not good enough, because attacks have changed. People have become much more sophisticated and it is going to continuously change. So it has to be a regular affair kind of thing. Cyber security advisory, threat monitoring has to happen on a current basis. You cannot say we will see. You need to have subscribe to these kind of threat monitoring tools, threat monitoring advisories. A threat monitoring capability, if you don't have it in-house, then you may need to subscribe to these. Very, very important on that thing. Where do we go from here? The future is going to be anywhere and everywhere. It is not going to be so a lot of people talk about work from home. Now the work from home is changing into work from anywhere and everywhere. So everywhere, so you need to give access. new normal will be that 50% or more your workforce is never going to come back to your offices. They may work from their offices, their hometowns. They may be traveling and working. So it is work from anywhere. Know the unknown. So unknowns we need to discuss. We need to say this is also possible. So let's not get into that cocoon and says nothing is going to go wrong. Yes, the new a problem is going to be very, very different. It has to be a seamless coverage. You cannot have silos that my IT security is done by one organization, my VPN is given by another, my this technology is given by, it has to be a seamless coverage. You need to know every aspect. It has to be a seamless part of it. You need to have a unified view. As senior management or the which is there, you may not be a privy to IT security, but you need to have a view of your employees. What kind of controls are they given? What kind of education are they given? You need to have unified view so that you can take action on that. Reduce human intervention. You need to invest in tools, because currently it is impossible to invest in human, and humans may not be able to give 24/7 coverage. You need to invest in technology and adapt continuously. Things are going to change. What I'm talking today, maybe 1 month down the line, there may be new attacks which are going to come, and things are going to be very, very different. So we need to adapt continuously and change it. So just to wrap it up, working from home will become a new normal. Yes, no cliche. Cyber diligence will be a new exercise. Any new employee, any new, so if any of you to hire, where they are going to work from, what kind of connectivity we have, what kind of devices are they going, cyber diligence, which we have not been able to, we are not used to, it will be a new, any third party vendors, any new organization any new partnership which you are doing, cyber diligence will be a part of it. Technology evolution will be multifold. So BYOD is currently, but BYOD 2.0 will be the new thing. More than 50%, you will have to be used to that kind of thing. Compliance and governance will become important. So currently, you have a policy of that pigeonholes, that everything you carry, you put it on lockers and then come within the organization. But when they are working from home, how will you control? How will you control what they are doing? The data which is there on their desktops, if they give it, take a picture from their mobile, how are you going to control those kind of things? So compliance and governance, privacy and regulatory issues. So four domains, I'll say compliance, governance, privacy and regulatory will have a different meaning in future. How do you cater for that? And that is where HR will play a huge role, because it is going to be all about people, which is there. A balance, fine balance between convenience, a great organization to work, trust factor and regulatory governance, compliance and privacy factors will be there. And prepare for unknown things which might come in future. We don't know what is going to happen in future. So be prepared for that. I think that's all from my end. Any questions, I'm happy to take it. Biplab, all yours.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much.
Let's open the floor for Q&A for 5-10 minutes. Yeah. And then we'll close. Any questions, anyone? I think we are between the lunch.
Okay.
I think Sandeep, do you have a question?
No question, sir. Just wanted to thank Pavan for sharing this wonderful insight on IT security and these things. Can we have this presentation also with us? I mean, that's a question.
Surely.
We'll share that across with you.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks for that. Yeah.
So thank you, Pavan sir, for the presentation and your talk about what we faced in the last 4-5 months and how things are changing every day, and how this should be a holistic responsibility, not just be left to silos, and how budget cuts should not be introduced, at least for cybersecurity. Thank you for sharing that insight with us.